This video tutorial is provided by the College of Graduate Studies at UCF. In this video, I will review the requirements for using equations and demonstrate how to apply the appropriate formatting changes. All equations, formulas, and symbols must follow the format of the approved style manual being used. A list of equations is not required, although all equations must be numbered. Equation numbers should be placed in parentheses near the right margin and aligned consistently throughout the document. Each equation or formula should also have adequate and consistent spacing both above and below to set it off from the text. Within the Word document, you can turn on the Show Hide All formatting button to view any pre-existing formatting. Because we'll be using a tab stop to align the caption rather than aligning the text itself, it can sometimes be easier to insert the caption before the equation. If you have an equation already inserted, place your cursor to the right of it. Otherwise, place your cursor in the line where you want the equation to occur. You can go to the Insert tab of the ribbon and select Insert Equation. Word provides pre-formatted equations, or you can create your own using the Insert New Equation option at the bottom of the menu. For this example, I will use a quadratic formula. This creates an equation box. I can always modify the equation within the box. Go to the References tab of the ribbon and select Insert Caption. In the label list, select the open parenthesis. If it is not in the list of labels, you will need to use the New Label button to create the label. Select a new label and in the text box, type an open parenthesis and click OK. In the caption box, type the space and a closing parenthesis after the number, then click OK. This will also apply the caption style to your equation, and the number in parentheses will be to the right of the equation. To separate the equation and the number, as well as right-align the number, we're going to create a tab stop. Typically, when you press the tab key, it moves the text over 5 spaces, or half an inch. When you create a tab stop, it overrides the typical tab and instead moves it however far you direct. In this case, we're going to use a tab stop to right-align the caption by moving it 6 inches to the right. With your cursor to the left of the caption, select the Home tab and go to the Paragraph section. Click the small gray arrow in the bottom right corner. From this menu, open the Tabs menu in the bottom left corner. In the text box under Tab Stop Position, type 6. This instructs Word to move the text over 6 inches when you press the Tab key. Change the alignment to right, then click OK. With your cursor still to the left of the first parenthesis, press Tab. This should move the parenthetical number to the right. If you prefer the equation to be centered, you will need to indent this line. The Center Alignment button will center the text, but it also includes the 6 inches of tab space within this alignment. Instead, use the hanging indent ruler to move your equation inward. Because the caption style of your equation also affects the captions for your tables and figures, I suggest making manual changes for each equation if necessary, rather than modifying the caption style. This concludes the video tutorial for equations. If you have any further questions, please use the ETD Help Request page available through the Thesis and Dissertation Services website. In the next video, I will review the use of appendices.